Down to the final two here at Skate Canada. And on the ice right now, the team that won the first event of the season and the team that had the lead after the original dance, Yelena Grushina and Ruslan Goncharov from Ukraine.
Well, that was nice to see that the movement in the previous dancers. This coach also skates in Newington, Connecticut, with Tatiana Tarasova.
And Dick, one more thought on what we just witnessed. Kulikova and Markov overtaking Denkova and Stavisky, who had a top five finish at the World Championships last year, but were instrumental in circulating that petition protesting the placements. Any thought on whether or not that could be some residue from that?
Well, I think the really important part was the fact that the program appeared to be a lot better than Denkova and Stavisky's program. And I'm hoping that that is what created the movement in the marks. If so, that'll be very satisfying.
Okay. Little slip by Yelena Grushina a moment ago. See if that cost them anything with the judges.
There's a lot of speed with this, and that's a very important element. These skaters, they have really very nice soft flow on the ice. Good knees. There's nothing stiff about it.
Earlier, we saw the team representing the U.S., Gregory and Petchikov. They're a married couple, and so is this couple. Yelena and Ruslan were married in 1995, and that's not unusual to see that in ice dance.
To that. Takes a little effort to get in and out of it. They're a lot softer this year than I think they were last year. It's quite possible that Tatiana Tarasova may have settled them down a bit. Sometimes taking a deep breath of letting it all happen is what it takes to make it look as beautiful as it can be. Turns in this step a little bit rough. But remember, as we've said, this is an early competition in the season, and the dancers have to give these programs a chance to settle in.
A large part of the process in the past involved skaters going to judges who gave them low marks and asking why and how they could improve. Guess what? You can't do that anymore. You don't know who gave you the low marks.
You know, that whole last move going into it, I don't know, it just didn't sort of flow for me as a move. The very end of it did. I liked the way it came down out of the lift and into the end of the music. But to get into that long lift, it looked like there was a lot of struggle in getting into it and a lot of sort of not quite flowing smoothly. I'm sure that will come with a little more experience in this program.
Was it a gold medal performance, though, here at Skate Canada? Find out in a moment as the judges are about to give their marks. But Grishina and Goncharov had the lead after the original dance, trying to win for the second time already this season.
Now, in this early part of the program, there was this kind of move. Side by side on the ice, he has a little bit of a jar there off that edge. I don't know if that's going to affect the judges very much. And in this move, watch the lift that he does. Swings her around and extends her. Now, that flowed more elegantly than the last one did. Although this latter part of it seems a little bit uncomfortable in making it continuous. Very tough moves to do.
Maya Usova and Tatiana Tarasova are busy today, aren't they? Coaching the last two teams, the Russians and now Grishina and Goncharov. We'll see. We'll see if the judges leave any room for the team from Canada, who are on the ice warming up right now. The first set, 5.0 to 5.8, a wide range.
Yes, and those are very good marks so far. You know, I mean, that's really very high.
Second set for presentation, 5-5 up to 5-8, and six of the seven judges putting them in first place. One second place from one of the judges.
Well, that was a nice program. It was a pleasant one to watch.
Certainly, though.